Allow me just to start by thanking the Holger Larsen Foundation and the Danish Cultural Institute for taking this important initiative. We at Ramble are very glad and proud to be associated with the many activities that are come under the India Today, Copenhagen Tomorrow headline. And we are particularly very excited to be associated with this competition that we launched today. Also, I would like to express our sincere gratitude to our honorary guest and patron, Mr. Nike, chairman of Larsen & Toubro, and a dear friend to Ramble through more than 20 years. Without your remarkable efforts, sir, the many Indian Today activities over the coming months would not have been possible. So thank you very much. Turning to the purpose of today's function, we can see this competition as a natural and logical extension of the Indo-Danish relationship that was initiated when the two Danish engineers, Henning Holl Larsen and Søren Toubro, established Larsen & Toubro in 1938. These two heroic gentlemen showed incredible courage and sense of innovation by bridging over the cultural and physical distance at that time. In many ways, this was how India became part of the Danish engineering history and Denmark became part of India's. Many Danish companies have benefited from Holger Larsen and Mr. Toubro's pioneering work in India and their success in creating one of the most respected and most professional companies on the Indian subcontinent. One of the companies that have benefited from this historic effort is Ramble. We were fortunate that one of our founders, Mr. Børge Ramble, had a personal relationship with Mr. Holger Larsen, like Mr. Holger Larsen had with many other Danish engineers and businessmen. And it's worth noting that this relationship between the two engineers were founded on a common interest in classical music, which made Mr. Ramble a frequent guest at the music events which Holger Larsen organized when he came back to Denmark every summer on summer holidays. This is indeed one of the many good examples of how business and culture go hand in hand. L&T and Ramble started our business relationship in the early 90s when I happened to be stationed in Delhi for 3 years assignment, and I was asked by Mr. Ramble and Mr. Holger Larsen to see if we could develop some business together. After a few years talking, we found a platform for long-term collaboration in the field of infrastructure and transport, and since our relationship has developed and become quite successful. Today our JV company, LT Ramble Consulting Engineers, is a key player in the Indian infrastructure sector, and we have close to 400 employees in Chennai, Hyderabad, Mumbai and in Delhi. In addition to our collaboration with Larsen & Toubro, Ramble has built a strong platform in other sectors in India, such as telecom, oil and gas and buildings, and today we employ more than 1,000 people in India. We are also fortunate to have a lot of Indian nationals working for Ramble in the Middle East, and increasingly so also here in Denmark. So, for Ramble, India has become one of our main strategic development areas outside of our North European home market. We have made India our main focus in Asia, and not because the Indian market potentially is huge, but more importantly because Indian engineers are very talented, highly educated, and come from some of the best engineering schools and technical universities in the world, all being in India. And this is exactly the kind of institutions and educational background that are needed to overcome the great challenges that we as societies face today. Nowhere in the world is the so-called megatrends more visible than in India. The challenges of urbanization, the environment, scarcity of natural resources, including energy and water, is so clearly part of the day-to-day experience of being an Indian citizen. And we need engineers and their technical skills to overcome these challenges. Having this function at the City Hall of Copenhagen is, in this context, a perfect setting. In this building, it was decided a few years ago, as the Vice Chairman mentioned, that Copenhagen should be the first carbon-neutral capital in the world by 2025. This is a truly co-creative effort that I'm proud to say that we have been part of from the very beginning. The Copenhagen Climate Plan is an example of the kind of ideas and solutions that we need to share on a larger scale. Thus, the vision of Copenhagen tomorrow, I believe, can serve as an inspiration and a point of departure for sustainable co-creation between Indian and Danish students, not just for the benefit of cities in India, but for many cities all over the world. As such, the competition we launch grows out of a fruitful history of cooperation and is, as we see it, an important part of passing the torch to a new generation with the new challenges that call for even more cooperation. Ramboll is proud to be part of this story, and we certainly see ourselves as a key player in the future cooperation of sustainable solutions between India and Denmark. Thank you.